It's time for you to unwind, cause tonight we gonna have a ball, y'all. From all over the world, we are bringing you the funniest new comics in Los Angeles. Welcome to Laugh After Dark. Ladies and gentlemen, get on your feet and make some noise for your host, Luc Ashley.
Hey, 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 hold up. Hold on, I don't, hold on. Oh. That's it right there. I can't see. I can't be a rapper. It's not gonna happen, not tonight. Shit. What's up, everybody? How you doing? Yes! Yes! You look good. You look great. I wanna be a rapper, okay? It's not gonna happen. So we're gonna listen to my first rap that I did in fourth grade tonight. You ready? Yeah. So I was a 2.0 student. No, I'm just gonna come out the gate. I don't want you to expect big words. I don't want you to expect fifth grade stuff. This was not fifth grade stuff. This was fourth grade stuff, okay? I found the book in the library and it was missing a page. And I was like, I don't wanna read this. I wanna read the whole book. So I put the book back. Then I found the page and I was like, this is calling my name. I should be a rapper. Okay, so here's the rap. If you don't like it, I don't care. You're gonna like it anyway. Sip a little from your little cup, sip a little, put it to your lip, cause it'll tip a little, tap a little, nine to your left, cause it'll drip a little, drop a little on the table, tap a little something on the mic, a little something for your ear, Luke Ashley just kicking with the flavor you like to hear. And then I get out of breath, cause I'm like, I'm heavier than I was in fourth grade. So, I can't be a rapper. Okay, let's move back. Let's go back to stand-up. How you doing? I like the orange. You're looking good. You're looking good. Thank you. What's up? What's up with y'all? What y'all doing? You laughing? Well, you do have some drinks. It's not drink after dark, okay? So we gonna make sure you got an Uber. Who let this nigga get a drink and come sit in the front row of this show? I don't even have a drink. How you get a drink? How y'all doing? You're nervous. White people, don't be nervous. You don't have to be nervous. You're in a very safe environment, okay? I mean, you're a little outnumbered. I'm just gonna say that. Yeah, just a little bit. I want you to repeat after me, okay? All the white people in the room, okay? Say it with me, you ready? Wakanda. Say it with me. Go ahead, your turn, go. What kind of hoe is it? That's what it is. That's what it is. That's what it is. Yo, y'all ready to hear some laughs tonight? I said, are you ready to get some laughs tonight? Up next on Laugh After Dark, Erica Dawson and Tavaris Smith. Welcome back to Laugh After Dark. Put your hands together for Erica Dawson!
Titty touch. Titty touch for you guys. How you guys doing tonight? We doing good? Yeah! Awesome. Awesome. I'm Erica Dawson. I like to do things weird. So we're gonna start off weird and fresh. A lot of people, you know, they like to maybe start a day with prayer, you know, start an afternoon with a little in touch with spirituality. I'm gonna start with my manifestation rap, which is similar to that. So I'm a snap. You can snap with me if you want, but this is just an opportunity for you to learn about me. All right, here we go. Yeah, get the beat. I'm a badass lady bitch here to manifest. I put it in a rap cause I'm sicker than the rest. Really, I have the worst fucking illness. Doctor says I only have a couple months to live and shit. No, I'm just yanking on your chain. I like to tell jokes cause I got a fucked up brain. Put retweets in your mind that'll make it ask why. Maybe one day even make a bad bitch cry. Of laughter, happiness, not tears and sorrow. But fuck it, I guess we'll have to wait till tomorrow. We gotta stay present to reap our rewards. Of laughter, even maybe surprise swords.
Yes, swords. That is what I said, because you never know when you get punched in the head. Then you need a sword. You've got a sword. What a great gift. That's a weird thought. Okay, let's shift. Remember when I said I was gonna manifest pre-positivity so you'd be fucking impressed? Well, here I go seeking your deepest approval, just like when someone goes and gets excessive hair removal, 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 removal. Here I go, manifestation. Everyone to love me and think that I'm great. I swear I try so hard. If we had a first date, just give me all your love. I'll do anything. I'll even be the one to buy the diamond ring. I wish that my grandma would come back from the dead. Then I'd tell her, I'm not stupid. I'm not stupid like you said. Want magical fairies to take away my pain. Drown down all these thoughts about being insane. This is why I manifest to address my fears. Get out my fucked up shit and justify my tears. You can call me crazy and I'm sicker than the rest, because I'm just an honest bitch that came to manifest. Best.
All right. All right. Yeah. All right. I'm feeling the fire. Feeling the fire. Thank you. Thank you. So, I clearly, I like to have fun. I dabble. And one of the ways I like to have fun is, I observe crazy people, so I watch a lot of Winona Ryder. Yes. Do we have any Stranger Things fans in the audience tonight? Yeah! Bitch is crazy. So, if you're unfamiliar, Winona Ryder, she plays a struggling mother, hashtag trauma mama, because she's lost her son. Oh, no. And if you haven't seen it, I'll just do a recap of 85% of her whole performance. It goes like this. My boy is missing! Where is my boy? Have you seen my boy? My boy! It is what it is. It is. So my friend and I were watching this, and we're like, this is about 90% of her entire, you know, content on the show. So we're like, fuck this. Let's make a drinking game, right? Let's go crazy! We put on Stranger Things season one. My boy, we take a shot. My boy, chug a beer. My boy, Jägerbombs, right? We're having a great time. And it sounds like a good way to get lit, right? On a Friday night, you'd have fun, right? My friend is dead now. He died that night. And the worst fucking part was honestly the funeral, because I personally couldn't stop laughing. Because, you know, as they were lowering his body into the ground, his mom was there. All she kept saying was, my boy! Oh, my God. It was fucking hysterical. It was. No, I actually need to make this kind of a serious note. I discovered something recently that is so shocking, jarring, horrifying, that I was like, you know what, Erica? If you don't tell this audience this tonight, it would be a disservice, you know, for your lives and mine. So, here we go. The pop hit My Humps by the Black Eyed Peas. We're familiar. It was sung in the wrong tone. Let me continue amongst the confusion, okay? Fergalicious, aka Fergie, sang My Humps as a secret feminist manifesto, okay? We're still confused. I am now going to sing My Humps as it was intended to be sung by Fergie. And I hope that some women feel empowered by this. All right, here we go. These are the same words. They say I'm really sexy. The boys all wanna sex me. Always standing next to me. Always dancing next to me. Trying to feel my hump, hump. Looking at my lump, lump. Oh, you can look, but you can't touch it. If you touch it, I'ma start some drama. You don't want no drama. Oh, no, no, no drama. You don't want no drama. So don't pull on my hand, boy. Oh. You ain't my man, boy. I'm just trying to dance, boy, and move my hump, my hump, my hump, my hump, my hump, my hump. Now fuck off. Thank you. I just had to get that off my chest, you know. I'm living with a brick in here. So I hope you guys feel a little more empowered now. I do. So a little more about me. I'm an actor. I go out to the theater to audition. And one of my more recent auditions, it was strange. I went out as Shakira's body double. So, you know, these celebrities, they have like someone who impersonates them, paparazzi follows them. And I was like, fuck it, I'm a quarter Mexican. Slap on a wig, some bronzer, let's go, lady. up to it. And they were like, okay, you know, we're in the room, and they're like, give us your best Shakira, give us a song. And I was like, okay. I'm on tonight, and all my hips don't lie, and I'm starting to feel it's right. And they were like, good, good, okay, we like you, we like you. Now, we want to see, you know, you're out in public, right? You're doing Shakira stuff, you know, normal every day. And I'm like, okay, all right. I'm trying to picture that, like, maracas, tits, you know, flying. And they're like, you're at a Starbucks. How would you order as Shakira? And I'm like, in this moment, I'm like, I can only sing as this bitch, you know? And I'm like, I got this. Venti, 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 nice, nice, nice. Please don't forget the almond milk. Leche, I meant leche! And then I didn't get the job. You really gotta commit to the character is what I'm trying to say, you guys. So, yeah, there we go. Thank you, I appreciate it. Yeah. I feel like, you know, we've got intimate with each other. So I'm gonna leave you guys with a song. Yeah, you play it. Yeah. You know, oop, I smacked my face. That's okay. I feel like we all have a lot of shame, you know, hidden in places. And I wrote this song about that. This is about my biggest fear in my tiniest hole. It's called Tiny. 1, 2, 3, 4. There's something that I need to get off my chest. And no, I ain't talking about my itty bitty breast. No, it's my tiny baby little hole. And yes, I am talking about my tight ass butthole. For every time I meet, yeah, a sexual man, he asks to put his dick in my mini shit can. With a booty so big, they say it'll surely fit. Then I have to explain my anus is smaller than my clit, 'cause I got a big old butt and a tiny butthole. Don't even think about asking me to do anal. Fuck off with a butthole so tight. You know it just ain't right. Don't try to stick it in or I'll scream in horror through the night. See, I have this friend. Her name is Sally. One night she let a man into her anal alley. Whoops, he got it real good. He got it real tight. But the next day she woke, she bled from her anus day and night. 'Cause she got a big old butt and a tiny butthole. Don't even think about asking her to do anal. Fuck off with a butthole so tight. You know it just ain't right. Now she got the hemorrhoids. Damn, do they put up a fight. Now you know about my sexual fears. For when your brown eye's bleeding, they're the worst kind of tears. Oh, now not everyone suffers from anal trauma, but I'll remind you again why I ain't in the bang home, mom. I got a big old butt, let's clap, and a tiny butthole. Don't even think about asking me to do anal. I'll die with a butthole so tight. You know it just ain't right. Don't try to stick it in, or I'll cut off your dick and fucking spite. I'll cut off your dick and fucking spite. I'll cut off your dick and fucking spite. I'm Erica. Thank you very much.
Hey, where you think you're going? Don't touch that remote, because we're coming right back. Now she got you picturing her tiny butthole. Welcome back to Laugh After Dark. Make some noise for Tavaris Smith.
How's everybody doing? That's great. Great to hear. It's good to see you guys. I've been going through a lot of things, a lot of family issues. I won't get too deep on you guys. My grandma thinks I'm gay. It's kind of awkward. She'll call me up on the phone. Grandma, what's up? What's going on? Where are you? Oh, you know, just at home hanging out. Do you have a girlfriend yet? No, Grandma, you know, I'm just focusing on comedy, you know. Oh, do you even like women? It's fucked up, man. She'll call me up, ask me if I want to go to church. Grandma, what's up? What's going on? Where are you? Oh, you know, just at home playing Xbox. You want to go to church with me in the morning? Damn, Grandma, I got to work. You know how that is, you know. Oh, do you even like women? It's fucked up, man. It's fucked up. But it's been a big year for me, though, man. I recently graduated. Thank you. Very kind. From medium to large shirts. Feels great. It's because I've been working out a little bit, you know what I'm saying? And I feel like you got to work out when you have an elderly scalp. Because when you're bald and skinny, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's too much room for jokes. You know what I'm saying? I get compared to all the bald celebrities, and it's never the attractive ones like The Rock or like Squirtle. You know what I'm saying? Like, my friends will be like, hey, dog, you know who you look like? And I'm like, who? Our penis. And it's just like, so disrespectful. Also, when you're bald and skinny, like, I constantly get disrespected. You know what I mean? Like, it's very upsetting. I was out one night on a date, you know what I'm saying, with this really nice girl, really family-oriented. She had a master's degree in, like, feeding dolphins or some shit. And we're just at a bar hanging out. I'm having intimate conversation. I'm doing my usual smooth talk, you know what I mean? Like, yeah, baby, so you watch wrestling? And and all of a sudden, this guy comes up behind her and starts tapping her on the head. Like, not hard, but just like... And she's like, oh my God, somebody's tapping me on my head. And I'm like, oh my God, somebody's tapping her on her fucking head. Like, he don't know me. I can know mixed martial arts. I can have a knife. Clearly he thinks I'm a bitch. I'ma say something. So after like 12 minutes, I finally said something, man. I said, hey man, stop tapping my girl on the head, man. What the fuck? But by then they were making out pretty hardcore, so like, I just got a to-go box for my potato skins and went home. Man. Round of applause if you've ever seen the movie The Blind Side. It's a great movie. It's one of my favorites. Great movie. If you haven't seen it, Sandra Bullock adopts a black dude. He goes to the NFL. They live happily ever after. It's very dope. I actually like the sequel a lot better. You might have seen it. It's called Get Out. It's a good one. It's a great movie, terrible for interracial relations. I can't bring white women around my black friends anymore. It's ridiculous. Like, they'll see me talking to a white girl in the club, you know, I'll be, you know, talking to a white girl, like, because that's how I talk to white girls. And all of a sudden behind me, I'll hear, oh, hell nah. And I turn around like, what, bro? Get out, bro. Get out. Like, that's not real, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's a movie, you know what I'm saying? There's no white women luring black men to the suburbs to steal all their black superpowers, you know what I'm saying? Besides the Kardashians and shit. Yeah. That'd be like if I was at home and my roommate came in and he was like, hey, man, I'm about to get some food. Do you want anything? And I go, you know, what are you going to get? And he's like, I'm getting Chinese food. And I go, oh, hell nah. Rush hour two, bro. Rush hour two. It's so stupid. But I moved here about a year ago from Wisconsin. Shout out to Wisconsin, anybody? You from, oh, shit. Yeah, it's very white. But I don't have a car here, so I basically Uber everywhere. And Uber gets kind of weird. Am I right?
Yeah.
Does it? Like, one night I was leaving the bar, slightly wasted, you know what I'm saying? And I called an Uber, and I'm like the only person on the street. And the Uber arrives, but he stops like 100 yards away from me. So I'm like, and he flashes his lights at me. So I'm like, dude, what the fuck? There's like clearly room for him to pull up. There's a lot of street left. So I do it again. And he flashes his lights again. So I take out my phone and I flash my flashlight at him. And he flashes lights again. So I flash my shit again. And then he just drove off. I was like, what the fuck? So I just finished peeing and, you know, I just caught a lift, man. It's fucking stressful. I've been trying to grow up. As you can see, I'm very immature. I just turned 30 later last year. Thank you for the applause. I appreciate that. And yeah, man, I've just been kind of collecting, you know, information of how I can like mature mentally. You know what I'm saying? Like, I buy candles now. You know what I'm saying? I eat meals with quinoa in it. You know what I'm saying? And I was in an Uber with a lady. She was older, and she was the driver. I was a passenger. And she said, this was around Christmas, and she asked me what I was doing for the holidays. And I said, nothing. I'm not around my family. And I asked her, what is she going to do? And she said, and I quote, so me and my 9 best friends, we get together with all our dogs, and we exchange dog treats and gifts and sweaters and boots for the dogs around a tree. And, you know, they just hang out, and they just have a blast. And I thought that was so incredible. I'm like, I had so many questions. Like, that's fucking amazing. Like, so many questions. Like, how the fuck do you have 9 best friends? You guys have been great, man. For this final joke, I'm gonna need some audience participation, if that's okay. Appreciate it. So, let me see, how do I do this? Does anybody have a single dollar bill? You have one? You've been great. All right, let's give it up for her. What's your name? Melissa, you're amazing. I appreciate this.
Single.
Single, you got it? Yeah, on Roll It, she got the rolled up single. I know what that means, rolled up single, binoculars, am I right? All right, cool, so, all right, audience participation. Thank you guys so much. You guys have been great.
Yo, we got some more coming up, so don't you go nowhere. And Tavaris, this is a PSA. Do not wear turtlenecks with that head. Love you! It's Lab After Dark! Yeah.